Taxpayers now owe more than $125 million for shorting officer pay. And your tab is rising by the second. Corrections officers tell me the state's holdout is causing more officers to quit and could be the reason for a spike in fentanyl exposures.
Six reported fentanyl exposures have been reported since Friday at one prison alone. That's according to the Missouri Corrections Officers Association, which reports the exposures are impacting both inmates and officers. The union says a staffing shortage is partly to blame. The union rep said it's so bad, the state has stopped putting numbers out. The rep added, the staffing levels are a lot worse than they were a year ago, when he said the Department of Corrections was 900 officers short November 2018. The union says morale is also suffering. Corrections officers have proven to judge after judge the state is breaking its own labor laws. Yet the Department of Corrections still won't pay officers when they arrive at work, despite repeated orders to do so. Officers are instead expected to volunteer the time it takes to get through the prison, get their equipment, and gather safety intelligence before their time clock begins. On average, that's about 2.5 hours of unpaid time per employee each week.
Late this afternoon, a Department of Corrections spokesperson disputed some of the union's facts, saying the state currently faces 800 officer vacancies, and they hope that will change with a scheduled pay raise January 1st. The spokesperson added that while there have been multiple reports of drug exposures, only one was confirmed by a hospital to be fentanyl, and the officer was quickly discharged. Meanwhile, the tab taxpayers owe for shorting pay keeps climbing with no comment from regulators as the state may take its fight to the Supreme Court. For the Fox Files, I'm Chris Hayes.